Hi, I'm Bryan Jensen with UW-Madison Department of Entomology and Division of Extension. Would like to talk to you today a little bit about black cutworm management in seedling corn. Black cutworms are an occasional pest on corn because they don't overwinter up here but migrate up to our state in spring weather fronts. So we never know for sure if that migration will be to our west, to our east, get stalled out to our south, or if we'll get a lot of moths flying up here. The immature stage is what causes the damage to our corn. Usually from emergence up to V4 stage of development. After that, the corn pretty much outgrows black cutworm damage. Here's an example of larger cutworms feeding on mid-size corn, V3, V4. They are burrowing into the plant below ground level, and they're feeding right at the growing point. And above ground symptoms that you'll see are this wilted whorl, and sometimes the plant may be laying over. So dig around within 2 inches of a damaged plant looking for the black cutworm, and you won't find them around every plant, but here we did find one. The immature stage at best is kind of a grayish color, light gray to dark gray, maybe sometimes black. But I look at both finding the worms and the type of damage that they cause before I say it's black cutworm damage in a field. I always advocate scouting each and every field that you've got, but I also understand in the spring you don't always have the time for that. So what I'd like to give you is a couple of hints to target fields which have the highest probability of seeing black cutworm damage. And those areas are corn planted after soybean stubble. For some reason, the adult female moth likes to key in on that soybean stubble to lay eggs. Also, you can find significant black cutworm feeding in fields that have low, dense, densely growing broadleaf weeds in them. And then finally, those fields with low-lying areas next to streams, wet spots, and things like that. To scout for black cutworm, I would suggest you walk a W-shaped pattern within a field. That gives us a good random assessment of the entire field. And at each of 5 areas, I would count the type, the damage that you have on 50 consecutive plants. So a field sample is 250 plants. The type of damage that cutworms cause is dependent on the size of the cutworm, and it's also dependent on crop stage. Small larvae can only cause holes in the leaf. They can only chew holes in the leaf. They cannot cause any cutting. Medium stage black cutworms can, on small corn, cut the plant. And large larvae are pretty much going to burrow into that plant below ground level, and your above ground symptoms will be what we commonly call dead heart or wilted whorl. So in probably 2 damaged plants in each set of 50 plants, I would dig up next to a damaged plant, dig up and try to find the worm. It's important to know how large that cutworm is, and the length of the cutworm is not very diagnostic. Rather, I would use the head capsule gauge that's in our Pest Management in Wisconsin Field Crops Bulletin. And finally, the economic threshold for black cutworms. We're only looking at the growth stage of V1 through about 3-4 on corn. And if you have approximately 5% damaged plants on field average, then it could be time to spray. There are really no cultural management characteristics or cultural management practices that you can use. For more information, please go to our extension bulletin A3646, Pest Management in Wisconsin Field Crops. Thank you.